ご覧のスポンサーの提供でお送りします。
Hey guys, Kakarot197 again. This time with a review of the high-grade Cosmic Era Dagger L from the Gundam Seed Destiny anime series provided to me by my favorite online hobby store, HobbyLink Japan. If you want your own, links down below. And in terms of looks, this is definitely the sleekest looking dagger you can buy at the moment. Compared to the old 105 dagger, everything has been slimmed down considerably. Something that is especially noticeable on the lower arms and the feet. It totally gives it a more serious vibe, and the engineering of this thing is also nothing to sneeze at. There's almost no seam lines to be found on this entire thing, and the dagger itself is completely color accurate. It doesn't even need any stickers. Unfortunately, it also doesn't come with any marking stickers either, which is one of my few complaints about the kit, which does say a lot about how good it is. So straight out of the box, we're getting a really awesome dagger. It's an easy and quick build with a fantastic end result. Grab some marking stickers and some top coat, and this thing will be perfect. So now let's have a look at the accessories that this thing comes with. Starting off with what's already on the machine, we get two beam sabers mounted on those pouches on the side, and of course they come with two new style long beam saber blade effect parts. And while we're talking about the pouches, I also quickly want to point out that normally inside of these should be one stiletto anti-armor rocket-propelled penetrator each, but not only do they not open up, which is completely understandable for a high grade, but we don't get these stilettos, period. For that, you're gonna have to buy the P Bandai kit. But back to the beam sabers, they fit absolutely perfectly in the hands, and they make for a really cool accessory with the dagger. And then we get to my second complaint about this kit, the beam carbine. Can you spot what's wrong with this? Exactly. The trigger guard is interrupted, and that is because we do not get a separate trigger finger hand for this thing. Instead, it just goes into either one of the normal holding hands. And so, well, because the trigger guard would get in the way, they simply decided to cut the trigger guard, and this also means that when he's actually holding it, it doesn't look quite right. Now, the reason that it doesn't come with a trigger finger hand is because the joints and also the hands are remolded from the high-grade Cosmic Era Ail Strike Gundam. And because of the design of the Strike's beam rifle, that kit could get away with it. But it's not all doom and gloom with the beam carbine. If you have a look at the scope of it, or the sensor, however you want to call it, you'll see that that usually very difficult to paint part is actually molded separately. So you can easily remove the white part and then paint the gray part behind it or put some kind of sticker on there. Unfortunately, we don't get a sticker for that with this set. And then already the final accessory we're getting is the typical dagger shield. And this time around, unlike the Windham, this red part is an actual part. Now, when we turn it around, you'll see that it does need a bit of work. We've got some hollow parts. This has to be painted gray, but nothing too difficult to overcome. Then, unlike many other model kits, it's got ball joints to move the shield around, and it also disconnects quite easily. Then to attach it to the dagger, it's got a system reminiscent of the old dagger, which also makes it so that there's no unsightly holes in the arm. When there's nothing there, you simply slide it on there and then it clicks into place. And if you look very closely, you can see those tiny indentations that it clicks into. And then the final thing that I quickly have to show is this runner with the leftover parts from the Build Strike Gundam. None of these are unfortunately very useful unless you want to use them for something else. So unfortunately, that's all of the stuff that it comes with. Despite being a Striker Pack compatible mobile suit, it doesn't come with a Striker Pack itself. But of course, you can attach other Striker Packs to it. So we're quickly gonna go over its compatibility. it should go without saying that it's perfectly compatible with the Jet Striker, because they even say so on the box and in the manual. Other backpack-only Striker packs then are also no problem. The ones that I've personally tested out are the new Ale Striker pack, the IWSP pack, the Noir Striker pack, the Gun Barrel Striker, and then from the Gundam Build Fighter series, the Build Booster backpack. All of them are a perfect fit. Then these Striker packs with shoulder parts essentially fit like you'd expect. The backpacks themselves are no problem, but there is of course no way to connect the shoulder parts, at least at this moment. You see, apparently canonically, the Dagger L should be able to use them, and underneath the shoulder armor, it's got this interesting looking area that looks like something might connect to in the future. So those who want a complete perfect Dagger L, don't lose hope just yet. Or, you know, grab some glue, because that always works. Oh, and talking about glue, the shields of the old Sword Striker and the Perfect Striker. Because the Dagger L uses a ball joint, the new shield isn't going to work, and as for the old shield of the Sword Striker, it doesn't work as is, but it looks like it might just go on there with friction if you cut down this peg. But in case that doesn't work, the one thing, again, that always works is glue. So with all of those accessories and Striker packs out of the way, let's have a look at the articulation of this thing, provided to it by the Ale Strike Gundam. Which means that this thing actually has a surprising amount of articulation for a modern grunt mobile suit. The head is on a nice hinge and ball joint combo, goes up like that, down like that, will of course rotate around all the way, and also has some forwards and backwards movement. The shoulders are on a ball joint with an extra hinge joint inside of the chest, so they'll go nicely forwards all the way like that, they'll go nicely backwards, up and down, and then there's an extra shoulder joint for upwards movement, so they also go nicely upwards. The arms rotate around below the shoulder, bend at the elbow on two joints, and this is why I said that that Ale Strike inner frame, well, it's the Build Strike inner frame really, gives this thing some really nice articulation for a modern grunt suit. And then the hands are on ball joints, will wiggle around, turn around, and do everything a ball joint does. But as shown by the waist, it's also got some of its own inner frame. The waist will go nicely forwards and backwards on a hinge, and then on a separate hinge, it'll also go side to side really nicely. Then it'll rotate around. The front skirts are molded together but can be separated and are on ball joints. The legs go forwards really nicely. Then they'll go backwards as far as the back skirt allows for, and the legs will go upwards all the way until the side skirts can't go any further, and when we remove the side skirts, they can potentially go up all the way like that. They'll also rotate around, and they also have that extra joint at the hips, which also shows us the action base connector. Then we've got a double jointed knee, this thruster goes up and down, and the feet are on the usual hinge and ball joint combo. They'll go forwards really nicely, backwards really nicely. They'll rotate around on that ball joint and will also go side to side on that ball joint. So yeah, I think all that needs to be said is that the amazing articulation this thing has packing for a modern high grade more than makes up for the fact that it doesn't come with a Striker pack. Not only does it look amazing, but it's got the articulation to make it look even more amazing. So as always, the inevitable question is, do you want to buy this? And for 1,200 yen, this is a very capable little kit. it's not quite perfect, but for the price, there isn't much to complain about either. Because seeing how many modern grunt high-grades use simplified and dumbed-down constructions compared to Gundams and other high-profile mobile suits, it's definitely cool to finally see another grunt with fully featured articulation and no, or well, almost no hollow parts. As a result, the Dagger L as a model kit is superior to the Windom, even though in the show it was the other way around. So grab yourself a couple of Dagger L's, grab some Striker packs, and have fun. For the price, this is a kit that I can totally recommend. For some size comparisons then, here it is next to the old high-grade 105 Dagger, and the absolutely horrendous no-grade vanilla Dagger. I really hope that this thing gets a high-grade Cosmic Era soon, because it's such a cool reimagining of the gym, and it more than deserves it. The 105 Dagger then, as outdated as it might be as a model kit, I still love it, so I personally don't need an upgrade right away, but it would definitely be cool to see it upgraded as well. Then here it is next to the high-grade Saigu and the no-grade Guaze. Two more machines I would kill to have upgraded to a sleek, modern, high-grade Cosmic Era kit. And then finally, here it is next to the standard size Gym Custom and the always bulky Zaku 3. And that has been all for this review on the Dagger L, a model kit that I've been waiting for a very long time. Again, if you want your own, links down below. And as always, a big thank you to the Patreon supporters. I hope everyone watching has a great day, and I'll see you all next time.